So as always, the rule with significant figures is that we can report all known digits plus one estimated digit. And with a digital instrument, one that just spits out the numbers for us, okay, like a mass balance. Suppose we have some compound here on our mass balance and it weighs 1.031 grams as determined by the balance. We can report all of those values with a digital instrument, report as long as it's not fluctuating at the end. We can report all constant values plus one estimated fluctuating value. So sometimes air currents will cause that last digit, that least accurate thousandth place or milligram place digit, to fluctuate around, and you just kind of have to say, well, it's kind of halfway between a number, and then make a guess. Okay, so to a known, if it's constant, we would just report 1.031 grams. If it's fluctuating around that last digit, that one at the end may have to be estimated based on the fluctuation. So digital, pretty easy to record in lab. An analog instrument, however, with a scale or a rule such as this ruler, okay, it's a centimeter scale, not to scale obviously, but we're going to go to the mark plus one estimated digit. Okay, and to the mark, we've lined it up with the zero line, so we're right on the line here, and we're going to go all the way and go to the mark. So what's the last mark that we see? Okay, so it's this line is the last mark that's known, and that happens to be, there's 0.5, so 0.6, 0.7. This is a millimeter rule line. So it goes all the way to 0.7. So we can go to that point, to the known mark, plus one estimated digit, looks like 0.73 or so. 0.73. So we have a known value of 0.7, and then we have an estimated value that's not directly marked of the 0.3. You might have said anywhere from 0.72 to 0.75 centimeters on this one, okay? Because the mark is, as we said, an estimate. One estimated digit. So now that we know how to measure from both a digital and analog instrument, let's look at the significant figures in a particular measurement. So the number of significant figures. Suppose I give you 1.031 grams like I did a second ago. Okay, so how many significant figures are in this? So there's a few rules. The first rule, ending zeros are not significant unless after a decimal place. Okay, ending zeros are not significant unless after a decimal place. Beginning zeros are never significant. Okay, middle zeros are always significant. Non-zero numbers are always significant. Okay, and so let's see. This number has one middle zero, it's significant, and three non-zero numbers, so it has four significant figures. Let's do a contrast here. Four. There we go. What if we have a number such as this? Beginning zeros are not significant, so these are not significant, but ending zeros after a decimal place are, and non-zero numbers are. So this has two significant figures. What about this number? One thousand, as written like this, has only one significant figure because ending zeros are not significant unless after a decimal place, okay, or in between significant figures. So if we want to make all the zeros significant in 1000, we put a point at the end, a decimal at the end. And so now we have middle zeros instead of ending zeros, so we have four significant figures. Okay, and if we have scientific notation, don't let it bother you. Scientific notation shouldn't bother you. 1.0 times 10 to the 3, say. 1.0 times 10 to the 3. Well, you just ignore the times 10 to the 3 and only look at the beginning part. And so we have 0 after the decimal place, and so this will have two significant figures. Okay, so just do some practice with that on your homework.